graduated here that will never be forgotten. You are not alone on this campus. You are surrounded by a family that will always stand by you and help you get back up.
So I love saying this in August. Happy New Year! Evangel is a campus where we love God passionately with our minds and our hearts and our hands extended in service. You hold an unlit candle that reflects our commitment to live in a community and declare the good news of Christ, his hope of the world.
There you go, you're welcome.
Our fire bowl declares that we are united in Christ as one body, one community, while still retaining our unique identities.
Today, we recognize an inescapable truth, that all journeys must come to an end. But before we end this chapter of our lives, let's answer one question. What did you do in your time at Evangel? Well, first off, you moved in. You met your roommate. You joined our community at Ignite. You went to your first class. You studied hard. You found your first friend group. You explored Springfield, you participated in floor events, and you spent way too much money at the barracks. You balanced your ministry with your schoolwork. You ran drills, sprinting and dribbling and hitting and tackling. The team was down, the clock was ticking. You hit the shot, you scored the goal, you crossed the line, you won the game. You cheered, you screamed, you roared. You clapped respectfully for the golf team. You directed a movie, you walked the red carpet, you took the stage, you tuned your instrument, you took a deep breath, you banged the drums, clashed the cymbals, strummed the guitar, pounded the keys, hit the high note, took a bow, you conducted experiments, you proved your hypothesis, and you won national awards. You embarked on missions trips, you ministered to our community, our country, and our world. We arrived as passionate freshmen, and now we're leaving as confident seniors. We dreamed big and achieved greater. But most importantly, we grew closer to the Lord. We formed a spiritual community. We found our calling, and we discovered a new family. We are so proud of all you've done at your time at Evangel. Today, we celebrate you. Welcome to Evangel University's Class of 2020 Virtual Commencement.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the virtual graduation ceremony for the Class of 2020. None of us could have imagined last March how this pandemic would impact your final semester or your commencement or our nation and world. But what can never be taken from you are the lifelong friends and relationships you've developed at Evangel and AGTS, the perseverance and resilience you've honed, the depth of your relationship with Christ, and the degree you have now earned. While this ceremony reflects the culmination of your academic degree program, to commence is actually to begin. Therefore, this service celebrates both the completion of your university academic degree and the beginning of this next season of your life. As graduates. While I don't know the journey that God has designed for each of you, I now trust you to his good care with full confidence that he will continue to hold you, guide your steps, and use your lives for his glory. As Dietrich Bonhoeffer wrote, "Only Jesus, who bids us follow him, knows the journey's end, but we know that it will be a road of boundless mercy." I offer you the prayer of Paul, first to the Philippians and then to the Ephesians. From Philippians, the first chapter, I thank my God every time I remember you. In all my prayers for all of you, I always pray with joy, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. It is right for me to feel this way about all of you, since I have you in my heart. And this is my prayer, that your love may abound more and more in knowledge and depth of insight, so that you may be able to discern what is best and may be pure and blameless for the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ to the glory and praise of God. And from Paul's prayer to the Ephesians, starting in chapter 3, I pray that out of his glorious riches he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all the saints to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. My prayer for you is that his love will continue to capture your hearts, transform you more and more into his image, sustain you in your journey, and shine through your lives as his presence in the world. It is our honor to send out you, our graduates, out from Evangel, 521 graduates strong. Today we are awarding 328 bachelor's degrees, 62 master's, 41 associates, 7 EDDs, and we are awarding 63 seminary degrees, 28 doctorates, 35 master's, including the Master of Divinity. Graduates of the class of 2020, we applaud you. To the many family members and friends of the graduating class of 2020, I also want to thank each of you on behalf of our graduates. Your graduates have succeeded in earning their degrees in large part because of your faithful support, prayers, and encouragement. So this is also your day of celebration. And I am not the only one offering congratulations. We have received numerous letters, including letters from our Missouri senators, congressmen, the Assemblies of God Alliance for Higher Education, our superintendent of public schools, who's already hired many of our education graduates. All have recognized your hard work to reach this milestone and have offered their congratulations to you on this day. And now, would you join me for the invocation delivered by graduate Sarah Marsiglio?
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you. We recognize that we can accomplish nothing worth celebrating without you, so we thank you for your provisions. We thank you for your provision of hope when things have seemed dim, and we thank you for your provision of peace when the loudness of the world creeps into our minds. We thank you for your provision of love when our identity has cried. We thank you of your provision of relationships, of the lifelong friendships that Evangel has brought into our lives. And though we may not have gotten the goodbyes that we desired, we thank you that they have a depth to them that will go the distance. We thank you for the relationships we have with our faculty and staff that invested in us like we were their own and slowly became family to us. We thank you for our family that supported, prayed, and cheered for us through the whole journey, in a way that we can never repay them back. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for what Evangel is to us, that it will forever be a part of our story, that we will forever look back at the impact Evangel made. And so I ask, Lord, that your favor and grace would remain on this school, Lord, that you would continue to do mighty things through and in Evangel. Lord, I ask for a fresh anointing over this class as we step into our careers or continue to walk in them, Lord. Let us be people marked with your grace, your truth, your love, and your integrity in all that we do. Let us grow in zeal as we continue to deepen our relationship and our understanding of who you are, yet simultaneously sit in the mystery of your nature. Lord, bless our lives. Guide our footsteps. Let us be people who have ears to hear, Lord. We love you, Jesus. We listen to you. We submit to you. I ask that you would rise up leaders out of this class that would step into their career and be unashamed in proclaiming your truth, Lord. I ask that you would bring a community to every student as they embark in their new adventure and in new locations. Lord, that a community that would strengthen them, that would encourage them, and that would challenge them in their faith, that would lift up their arms when they are weary. Lord, I ask for fresh vision and fresh dreams over this class, that we would walk unashamed into them and have the courage and boldness to pursue what you have planted in our hearts and in our minds. And with all our strength, we would love you properly. Lord, you are so worthy of every breath, of every moment, so we devote our lives to you, but we need you, Lord. We need your presence, Jesus. You are our God. You are our Savior. You're our Lord, our friend, our comforter, our peace, our anchor, our refuge, our hope. You alone are God. And Lord, let that always be enough for us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Our commencement reading is from Romans 8, starting with verse 28. And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. For those God foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. Those he called, he also justified. Those he justified, he also glorified. What then shall we say in response to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who then is the one who condemns? No one. Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we will face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. And in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 6 and verse 13. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
Thank you. The amount of change that God has done in my life is honestly miraculous. You know, I came in here freshman year as a boy of this world, and I will leave here as a godly man for sure.
I always knew about Evangel because we were so close to Springfield, but really what did it for me was just I took a tour and just the spirit here, it was just different.
The thing I love most about Evangel is it has just this awesome church camp feel.
Evangel's kind of been a part of my life this whole time because my dad went here. As soon as I came to Springfield, it honestly felt like home.
Our cohort that I was a part of made all the difference. We were so close-knit, always cheering each other on. We were each other's biggest champions.
You know, the cheer team was a really big impact on my life. Anytime that we would have a rough day, we could always bring it to the practice. And before practice started, we would just circle up and just lay our hearts out. And then after practice, we could hang out and really just rely on each other to build each other up.
Even at my lowest point, my friends, my leaders, and my professors would just step in without being asked and just encourage me and guide me along the way.
I mean, I've had professors stay until 8 o'clock before, helping me understand concepts in chemistry because chemistry is hard.
For me, having a community that really pushes you towards exploring and learning for yourself and really evaluating for yourself has been super influential because there were large periods of growth that I've had over the last 3 years.
God can talk to you anywhere, but I think this place really offers an amazing opportunity for him to work and move.
I'd say the biggest change that I've noticed in my spiritual life here is from my prayer life. Being able to dive deeper into prayer and taking these Bible classes here and essential Christianity, I'd say it's very helpful and impactful.
I will always remember when I was sitting in a chapel and just became so overwhelmed by the Lord's presence. I began to weep and overwhelmingly just thank the Lord for where he has brought me.
I probably wouldn't have got my degree because of what I was walking through in life. And so the adult study specifically worked out perfect for my life because it kept me in the Word, it kept me grounded. I was earning a degree, so it was just kind of positive all around.
I don't think I quite realized how much I was going to gain from college, and it's not just knowledge. I've gained so much more just in emotional intelligence and life experience and how to make good friendships and how to find yourself. And so college has been a very good experience. 18-year-old Jess would be proud.
It is now my joy to introduce our 2020 commencement speaker, Steve Grant, a 1976 alumnus of Evangel. Shortly before recording his commencement address, Steve was awarded an honorary doctorate of humane letters, the most significant tribute conferred by the Board of Trustees for having demonstrated extraordinary achievement, service, and distinction in his vocational calling as a broadcast journalist, and whose service and accomplishments reflect at the highest level the mission and values of Evangel University. Now let me tell you a bit about Steve Grant. A 1976 graduate of Evangel, Steve began his career at KY3, NBC-TV, in 1974, while still a student at Evangel and just after his 20th birthday. For decades, he anchored the number one rated morning news show on the NBC network and currently serves as the noon and evening anchor. KY3 is historically one of the top five NBC affiliates in the country and is considered one of the legacy stations of the NBC television network. Over the years, Steve's assignments have taken him to every city, town, and county in the station's vast viewing area. As a traveling correspondent, he has reported from New York City, Washington, D.C., Hollywood, and even Vatican City in Rome, and has anchored and reported more than 25,000 newscasts. Because of his reputation as a wise leader and a calming presence, Steve was handpicked among all of the NBC broadcast journalists in the nation to go to WDBJ in Roanoke, Virginia in August of 2015. After two journalists were murdered while on the air. One of my favorite pictures of Steve is of him comforting the morning anchor on air the morning after her two colleagues were murdered. Throughout his career, Steve has interviewed people from local neighbors to national leaders, including Ambassador Jean Kirkpatrick, broadcast legend Paul Harvey, music legend Andy Williams, and many governors and senators. Off camera, Steve Grant met President Nixon and the Dalai Lama and prayed the Lord's Prayer with Pope John Paul II. He served as the announcer for Dan Betzer and Revival Time, the weekly Assemblies of God radio broadcast, for years until it went off the air in 1995. Steve has received numerous awards and recognitions for his service and work. He has not one but two Emmys, the Mid-American Emmy Association for Best News Coverage, and currently serves as the Emmy Chapter President. In 2016, Steve was inducted into the Emmy Silver Circle by the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences, Mid-America chapter, for his years of significant contributions in broadcasting. Steve was Evangel's 2010 Distinguished Alumnus and was one of the first five members of Evangel's Communication Department's Wall of Fame. And he has received numerous other awards over the years from the Missouri Broadcasters Association, the Associated Press, and the Kansas City Press Club. Steve is also known for his heart of compassion and community service. He has served on numerous civic, religious, and charitable organization boards, including the Kitchen Homeless Shelter and the Springfield Sheltered Workshop, and has visited Kenya on medical mission trips. He was the spokesperson for 16 Ozarks honor flights, and through KY3 helped raise over $1 million to take 1,300 World War II veterans to the World War II Memorial in Washington, D.C., which set a record for the National Honor Flight Program. We often talk about Evangel graduates serving as the presence of Christ in the world, both in vocational ministry and in the marketplace. And at the highest levels of his profession, Steve is recognized as a man who is both a consummate professional as a broadcast journalist and as one who lives his faith as a winsome witness in the church and in the marketplace. In fact, his former news director, who then became a national executive, said, "From the time Steve Grant left Evangel, then college, his life works have modeled the advice from Proverbs, 'Do not withhold good from those to whom it is due, when it is in your power to act.'" Steve is recognized at the highest levels of his profession as one who is both good and consistently does good for others. As I've watched and gotten to know Steve over the years, we were actually classmates for a couple of years, he's an inspirational model of one who lives by what the ancient prophet Micah wrote, that God said was good, and what he requires of us: to act justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with our God. I present to you Steve Grant, recipient of the Honorary Doctorate of Humane Letters and our 2020 commencement speaker.
Hello, class of 2020, and all those so very proud of you. There are three great honors in life, I think. The woman I love asked me to marry her, the recognition of one's peers and of your alma mater, and this, a once-in-a-lifetime invitation to share these unrepeatable moments of thanksgiving with you. Some of you helped write these remarks, and thank you for that. So with a little nod to late-night TV, we present the top 10 reasons to graduate from Evangel. Number 10, from Josiah Dinwiddie, the chicken strips in the joust. Apparently, Josiah is auditioning for some show. Melody Ball, because I know I am a handful. Jennifer Page, when you're at the end of your rope, someone else lets you use theirs. Brianna Berry, growing is encouraged. John Guzman, God is in my education. Number 5, Alexandra Ross, equipped for God's calling. Mimsy Robinson, I like your name, Mimsy. Everything I learned had 2 feet on the ground in the real world of ministry. Becca Holland, there is peace, opportunity, and wisdom here. Melinda Yost, the faculty was the foundation to my success. And number 1, from Hannah Tollison, there is an amazing legacy of graduates from Evangel, Central Bible College, and the Assemblies of God Theological Seminary. Very true, Hannah. We'll come back to that a little later. My favorite author is Frederick Buechner. I've always wanted to interview Frederick Buechner. Now, some of you seminarians may recognize his name, and he has some telling words about the sacrament of this present moment and the years ahead of you. He says, "The grace of God means something like this. Here is your life. You might never have been, but you are you because the party wouldn't have been complete without you here. Here is the world. Beautiful and terrible things will happen. Don't be afraid. I am with you." Certainly, 2020 still seems bent toward the terrible in some ways more than the beautiful. Our waking moments menaced by a rogue microbe straight out of the Old Testament, painfully working or not working through a forced recession, and an ongoing reckoning with the blowback of indifference. You are receiving your degrees while we're all in a crash course of managing what one researcher now calls life quakes, navigating crosswinds and the challenges of whitewater rapids of change. Most of us no longer on a predictable path, yet life in the zigzags can take us to better places. Somewhere along my ecumenical journey, someone seeing a stumbling servant handed me a prayer card that fits so well with a virtual commencement ceremony in a pandemic. It says, "May you trust God that you are exactly where you are meant to be. May you not forget the infinite possibilities born of faith. Allow your soul the freedom to sing, dance, praise, and love. It is there for every one of us." We are not without hope, and this celebration is all about calling down blessings on your future. The psalmist said, "The Lord will work out his plans for me, fulfill his purpose for me, perfect that which concerns me." In other words, always refuse despair. And this from Matthew's gospel, divine assurance from the voice of grace. Because of your faith, it will happen. Jesus, our brother, teaching to live life trusting God as he did, to be active in our tomorrows as he is. There's a captivating TV commercial about finding and living a life of meaning. It was produced by an Atlanta advertising agency. It's a Nike ad called Redefine Your Impossible. Youthful voices ask viewers two soul-stirring questions. While you write your story, what will you show them? Does your passion compel you to act, or will it remain a dream? And here's the punchline. The true measure of passion is what you do with it. The spot ends with the words "Redefine Your Impossible" on the screen and a famous Nike swoop. When I shared the impressiveness of that message and that spot with my friend and Central Assembly pastor Jim Bradford, he said, "Sounds just like Carol Taylor." Well, certainly, Dr. Taylor has redefined the impossible and with a servant's heart tested by fire, turning around one campus on the brink of closure and then coming to Springfield to consolidate three schools with significant challenges. Viewed overdue by many, sacrilege by some. At all times, conducting herself with quiet strength, decisiveness, influential insight, and spiritual care. In the words of one of her colleagues, she is uniquely unique. Wouldn't that be great to have on your resume? Uniquely unique. Several years ago, a pastor who happens to be an evangel grad gave wise counsel to a longtime friend discouraged over not fitting into regular church life. Matthew Newman advised not to worry about racking up gold stars for perfect attendance. Matthew told his friend, "Maybe your role is influence." When you think about that, maybe it's everyone's. A ministry of presence. If we are to be examples worth following, then we are following the example worth following. Jesus said, "He is the way. His Spirit in your work can light up the room." And I really like how the president of Fuller Seminary, Mark Laberton, frames all of this for us. He says, "Any true disciple is in some measure meant to be a leader, one who affects others by the way he or she lives, acts, and speaks. Jesus-following leaders are needed everywhere, those with a vision grounded in the hope of grace and love of Christ." We already have enough clowns and sparklers. Those elements of character and virtue are evident over the decades in the stellar lives of the alumni you are joining, where and why they serve, and what they do. They are indeed those better angels who discovered a mighty purpose. We live in a moment when our faith in national figures is waning. America seems to have lost the capacity to produce enough leaders of intelligence, empathy, compassion, and courage. It was C.S. Lewis who warned long ago not to trade away grace for power. Instead, reality TV packaging, celebrity popularity, tweets, and maximum exposure drives society's whims. The turn-on, as consultants call it. Christ was the quiet guest at the wedding in Cana. He did not arrive in a limo with an entourage or the media in tow. In God's sight, the things that really matter seldom take place in public. Henry Nouwen observed that while we focus on the VIPs, their causes, peace conferences, and protests, it's the totally unknown people working and praying in silence who make God save us yet again from destruction. So lead where you are and love. Shepherd Doherty is 2 years old now. He lives in Boston with his dad, Justin, the news anchor, and his beautiful mom, Sydney. Yes, they're Evangel alums too. Before Sheppy was born, Justin would speak these sacred words to him as Sydney slept, and he wrote them down for his little son to hold on to as he grows. Love the Lord with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. Do not be worried about your life. Seek his righteousness, and all these things will be added. Have love for others. People will know you are his disciple. And from the book of Justin, when you do anything, do it as if the world is watching. To me, the profoundness of these personal moments is the medical knowledge that babies on the way can indeed hear our voices. We can only imagine what Sheppy's story will be one day. Now, when your story is told, I hope your reputation will have been built on faith and values. I hope whenever people talk about your accomplishments, they will speak not only about what you've done, but also the person you are and what and who you stand for. And now we end where we began, with more of Frederick Buechner's words of wisdom. I couldn't resist. I wish they could print these on the back of your degree. He says, "We have it in us to be Christ's to each other, to work miracles of love and have them worked upon us. We have it in us to bless with him and forgive with him and heal with him. It is our business to speak, to bear witness and live out and toward and by the true word of his holy story." God bless you and keep you. And God bless Evangel.
It is truly an honor to personally congratulate each one of you, our 2020 graduates of the Evangel University College of Arts and Sciences, the College of Adult and Graduate Studies, and the Assemblies of God Theological Seminary. On behalf of the EU and HETS faculty, I want to express how proud we are of each of you and your outstanding efforts in reaching this significant goal under very difficult circumstances. Graduates, with these degrees you're awarded today, I pray that God will bring to you opportunities to serve the kingdom in ways you never thought imaginable. Congratulations, graduates. Well done. Now it is my pleasure to present you to the president for the conferral of your degrees. President Taylor, on behalf of the faculty of Evangel University, I am pleased to present to you the class of 2020. By their fulfillment of academic requirements and their faithfulness to Christ, the members of this class have demonstrated their readiness for graduation. As authorized by the faculty, it is my pleasure to recommend to you these candidates for the conferring of their respective degrees.
Now here's the moment you've been waiting for, the official awarding of your degree. We are so very proud of you. Ready? Here we go. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Evangel University, by the State of Missouri, and by the General Council of the Assemblies of God, I hereby confer upon you, the class of 2020, the respective degrees which have been earned by each of you, together with all the privileges and obligations pertaining thereto. I now declare you graduates and alumni of Evangel University and the Assemblies of God Theological Seminary. Congratulations and God's richest blessings on all 521 members of the 2020 graduating class. Professors Bob Berg and Jennifer Morrison will now read all of the names, degrees, and honors of our graduates, organized by school and department. Below this video, you will find the order of presentation and the time that each school and department will be recognized, so you will know when to get your phones, cameras, and those air horns ready. Congratulations again.
Doctor of Philosophy degrees, David Osbury. Donna Krstulovich. Stephen Krstulovich. Mark Murphy. Adrian Rosen. Linda Seiler. Stephen Skipper. Stephen Todd. Doctor of Applied Intercultural Studies degrees. Kalaba Chali. Murphy Matheny. Theon Piang. Mimsy Robinson. Eileen Ruger. Jennifer Schaefer. Doctor of Ministry degrees. David Cameron. Stanley Cook. Jesus Galindo III. Kelly Goins. Eleanor Quay. Peter Landers. Christy Lemley. Raphael Machuca. Paul McDonald. James Merritt. Herschel Rosser. Shane Schlesman. Chad Slata. Darnell Williams, Sr.
Master of Divinity degrees. Maurice Bell, Jr. Shem Shin. Alicia Dare Esker. Garen Forsberg, cum laude. Mark Harris. David Luffy, summa cum laude. Levi Parody. Jiang Yun. Master of Arts degrees. Olivia Carter. Jonathan Cron. Deborah Gallion, summa cum laude. Gary Grogan, magna cum laude. Bernard Kimani. John Koshal, summa cum laude. Gloria Lee. Samuel Popa. Jonathan Rittenauer. Glenn Wenzel, summa cum laude. Master of Leadership and Ministry degrees. Alex Bryant, Jr., magna cum laude. Nathaniel Calloway. Michaela Claspill, magna cum laude. Blake Egeman, magna cum laude. Debbie Gillespie, magna cum laude. Christopher Gross, cum laude. Pamela Harry, magna cum laude. James Leisure, cum laude. James Logan. Harvey Martin Jr., magna cum laude. Jeffrey Morgan. Lisa Potter, summa cum laude. Paul Westcott III, magna cum laude. Shannon Wooten. Master of Pastoral Leadership degrees. Claude Domingue. Sarah Taylor, summa cum laude. Brian Vickers.
Doctor of Education degrees. Brian Breeden. Janine Forrester. Stephanie Long. Faith Swickard. Jennifer Talbert. Kyan Weaver. Keisha Wergler.
Master of Education degrees. Teresa Alverson. Jessica Botts. Cassidy Childers. Caitlin Hong Chubkowski. Antonio De La Torre. Tiffany Hill. Lindsay Keltner. Caleb Lusinger. Caleb McBain. Darla McDowell. Brandon Moore. Ryan Morris. Megan Reed. Allison Tate. Madison Thompson. Sunny Williams. Sarah Yoakum. Master of Organizational Leadership degrees. Megan Abney. Edward Boyle. Benjamin Brandell. Jennifer Cochran. Ashley Edmonds. Bruce Edmonds. Joanne Henry. Brent Johnson. Craig Kellogg. Brooke Kendall. Jimmy Ladd. Bernadette Losh. Stacy Lynn. Sarah Pogue. Yordis Quevedo. Alicia Richardson. Laurel Sturgill. Samantha Tyler. Timothy Walthall. Cody Winkler. Master of Science degrees. Caleb Boston. Nicole Quartz. Michael Crawford. Andrew Delisio. Bridger Falkenstein. Hannah Fawcett. Adam Faulkner. Lindsay Foundopoulos. Christopher Hall. Helen Hansen. Kara Heap. Emily Hurst. Sonia Iliff. Emma Kirk. Cami Krasnov. Michelle McComb. Kylie McKay. Corey Neal. Mackenzie Schmid. Carissa St. Clair. Mark Sullivan. Taylor Textor. Madeline Vincelon. Jennifer Wilhelm. Chi Yang.
Bachelor of Science degrees in Behavioral Health. Melody Ball. Christina Begay. Lauren Bright. April Burrow. Tara Colucci. Ryan Hand. Kamisha Jones. Tessa Kelly. James Morrison. Zachary Reeves, cum laude. Destiny Wrench. Patricia Sharpenstein. Hope Soffletti. Jan Walton. Caitlin Witted. Rochelle Yope. Melinda Yost, magna cum laude. Bachelor of Science degrees in Business Management. Anitra Appleby. Tyler Binkley. Kevin Bollinger. William Davis. Megumi Dixon, cum laude. Dwight Fay. Tori Gooch. Sarah Google. Caitlin Heath. Janice Hodges. Nicholas Holm. Gergana Kuzmanova, cum laude. Joyce Lancaster. James Lewis, cum laude. Taylor Long. Shay Medley, cum laude. Crystal Miner, magna cum laude. Ashley Ortiz. James Phillips II. Cheyenne Voiles. Kaylee Williams, cum laude. Bethany Young, summa cum laude. Bachelor of Science degrees in Church Ministries. Jacob Bradley. Jennifer Counts. Sierra Cross. Stephen DiLorenzo. David Forrest. Nicole Hines. Michael Janitis, summa cum laude. Patricia McAnulty, magna cum laude. Michael Seals, cum laude. Amber Stogsdill, cum laude. Mark Thorne. Weston Vaughn. Kimberly Voss. Kyle Walsh. Eric Wilson. Robert Yaniki, cum laude. General Studies degrees. Travis Cloud. Courtney Kettering. Robin Ace. Margaret Becourt. Zachary Labby. LaDonna Moore. LaChandria Powell. Joshua Watkins.
Baccalaureate degrees in the Behavioral and Social Sciences Department. Kaylee Anderson, magna cum laude. Sarah Barnes. Molly Bixler, magna cum laude. Josiah Borders. Sydney Bossetto. Sheila Boswell, cum laude. Sarah Bradshaw, cum laude. Kayla Bray. Joshua Cheesham, cum laude. Jade Cotney, summa cum laude. Elizabeth Conrad, cum laude. Joshua Conrad, summa cum laude. Hannah Cox, summa cum laude. Madison Cox, magna cum laude. Allison Davidson, magna cum laude. Madison Davis. Taylor Davis, summa cum laude. Brooke Donaldson, cum laude. Macy Duran, summa cum laude. Sydney Farless. Alexis Ferris, summa cum laude. Joshua Gass. Patrick Gall. Caleb Graveau, cum laude. Jessica Haney, magna cum laude. Brendan Hill. Rebecca Holland. Maxwell Holloman, summa cum laude. Victoria Johnson, cum laude. Jalen Jones. Janessa Juarez, cum laude. Mariah Kaiser. Elizabeth Lackey, magna cum laude. Riley Llewellyn, cum laude. Danielle Lumadou, summa cum laude. Genesis Manglona. Haley McCormick. Olivia Metzner, cum laude. Natalie Morales, cum laude. Sarah Nice, magna cum laude. Stephen Oakley, summa cum laude. McKinley Pontius. Alexandra Riddle. Joseph Roberts, summa cum laude. Bailey Sisko. William Stringer. Brent Tiemann. Bryce Todd. Macy Wade, summa cum laude. Christy Watsky, summa cum laude. Lauren York, summa cum laude.
Baccalaureate degrees in the Business Department. Nicholas Almiller, magna cum laude. Brooklyn Barnett, cum laude. Drake Carpenter, magna cum laude. Clara Chavez. James Collison. Taylor Culp. Rachel Dadian, summa cum laude. Nate Davis. Madeline Dixon. Catherine Eby. Kayla Einerson. Taylor Good, magna cum laude. Lauren Gore, summa cum laude. Kalisha Gray, summa cum laude. Jessica Haney, summa cum laude. Cameron Hardesty. Colin Irvine. Benjamin Johnson, magna cum laude. Elizabeth Kaffenberger, summa cum laude. Elizabeth Katz. Adam Lucht, summa cum laude. Macy Lung. Stephen Lupo, magna cum laude. Sarah Martinoff. Mindy McClaskey. Whitney McDermott, summa cum laude. Garrett McGuire, magna cum laude. Samuel Morton. Madison Orr. Austin Page. Joshua Pennekamp. Brooke Pinieri, cum laude. Caleb Pilcher. Brenna Plaster, summa cum laude. Andrew Poppin, magna cum laude. Caitlin Posh, summa cum laude. Abigail Roy, summa cum laude. Mackenzie Sasha Duran, magna cum laude. Tanner Stark. Daniel Stetzel. Madeline Stiegemeyer. Kyle Stolz, summa cum laude. Rebecca Varju, magna cum laude. Lillian Warman, summa cum laude. Meredith Weick. Abigail Wilkins. Sierra Williams.
Baccalaureate degrees in the Communication Department. Grace Ayers, cum laude. Jordan Beers. Taylor Bergquist, magna cum laude. Brianna Berry. Holly Black, magna cum laude. John Christopher Collins. Micah Daniels. Nigel Davison. Josiah Dinwiddie. Victoria Dixon. Jalen Gifford, summa cum laude. Emily Groves. Victoria Huera, summa cum laude. Josie Hewlett. Demarius Little. Shayna Manusos. Jace McQueen, summa cum laude. McKenna Moen. Bailey Olson. Grace Perkins, summa cum laude. Michelle Rutherford. Brianna Rivera. Megan Rogers, summa cum laude. Emily Rose. Luke Slater. Jacob Smith.
Baccalaureate degrees in the Education Department. Tiffany Acker. Casey Bright, summa cum laude. Rochelle Dossel. Maurice Downey. Natalia Estrada. Sydney Follis, summa cum laude. Chantel Gamlin, summa cum laude. Nicole Gore, summa cum laude. Rebecca Grallman. John Guzman. Christy Hafner. Micah Hall. Victoria Hartenberg, cum laude. Catherine Herzog, magna cum laude. Brooke Hove, magna cum laude. Isabella Eisnagel. Elisa Correll. Amanda Latham, magna cum laude. Caitlin Marsh. Megan McDonald. Jada Moore, magna cum laude. Kylie Moore, magna cum laude. Mariah Moorish, summa cum laude. Leslie Perona, summa cum laude. Jordan Poppin, magna cum laude. Karen Quijada, summa cum laude. Michaela Sack. Cassandra Schmidt, summa cum laude. Danielle Sorensen, magna cum laude. Courtney Spencer, magna cum laude. Jordan Stacy, summa cum laude. Kayla Stelmach, magna cum laude. Madeline Thompson, magna cum laude. Abigail Wegner. Cheyenne Welch. Corey Weens. Rachel Williams, magna cum laude.
Baccalaureate degrees in the Humanities Department. Joella Abarrientos. Alyssa Bennett. Catherine Carrico, cum laude. Alyssa Ferris, magna cum laude. Brianna Ferris. Emily Folk. Adam Gillen. Emma Hill. Abigail Holmes, summa cum laude. Rebecca Leathers. Josiah Love. Allison Maddox. Elise Nelson. Erin Payne, magna cum laude. Hannah Shearer. Nina Smith, cum laude. Kristen Stewart. Nicole Stoker, summa cum laude. Hannah Tollison, summa cum laude.
Baccalaureate degrees in the Kinesiology Department. Jansen Acklin. Arlena Armstrong. Kelly Bixler, magna cum laude. Clark Brewington. Morgan Brown, magna cum laude. Anna Carpenter, magna cum laude. Christian Clardy Lopez. Joshua Cochran, cum laude. Tyler Conway. Caitlin Cox, cum laude. Kylie Cox, magna cum laude. Amber Ellis, summa cum laude. Benjamin Friend. Joanna Hetnick. Sydney Hausnecht, summa cum laude. William Jackson. Kristen Johnson, summa cum laude. Rachel Lane, summa cum laude. Marcus Means. Allie Pritchett. Colton Sherman, cum laude. Michaela Stephen, summa cum laude. Danielle Sutton, magna cum laude. Dalton Taylor. Lexi Vaught, cum laude. Shannon Vickery. Miles Williams. Jerry Womack.
Baccalaureate degrees in the Music Department. Edward Beale, magna cum laude. Leanna Cantrell, magna cum laude. Kaylee Dudkowicz. Hudson Freeman. Rebecca Freeman, cum laude. Alexa Gambino, magna cum laude. John Helton, magna cum laude. Andrew Hendrickson, magna cum laude. Laura Holman, summa cum laude. Elijah Horton, magna cum laude. Kelly LaFon, summa cum laude. Victoria Mora de Palo Marquez, magna cum laude. Rachel Moore, magna cum laude. Jennifer Page, cum laude. Christopher Pereira. Cassidy Shorey, magna cum laude. Jordan Spence, magna cum laude. Derek Van Wy. Josiah Vanderberg. Trayvon White. Gregory Worthley, summa cum laude.
Baccalaureate degrees in the Natural and Applied Sciences Department. Megan Anderson, summa cum laude. Anne Annabelle, magna cum laude. Barrick Barton, magna cum laude. Olivia Bates. Joshua Bauman. Alexandra Bornert. Catherine Bussard, summa cum laude. Madison Christensen, cum laude. Mackenzie Cox, magna cum laude. Levi Coyle, magna cum laude. Maggie Kreider, magna cum laude. Karina Quate, summa cum laude. Heather Culbertson, summa cum laude. Caleb Kelly, magna cum laude. Garrett Kyle, cum laude. Jacob Meyer, summa cum laude. Natalie Murphy, magna cum laude. Linda Patton, summa cum laude. Isaiah Sashaduran, summa cum laude. Kimber Schaefer, magna cum laude. Mark Seiler, cum laude. Jonas Taylor. Casey Weatherly, summa cum laude. Dylan Wielborg, summa cum laude. Charles Wilhelm. John Woodruff.
Baccalaureate degrees in the Theology and Global Church Ministries Department. Cruz Allen. Amy Alverson. Cole Atkins, Jasmine Bruner, magna cum laude, Carter Burns, Hannah Butler, Mackenzie Circsena, Matthew Collins, Jordan Fiorani, magna cum laude, Donald Fregale, Noah Hegeman, Aaliyah Kent, magna cum laude, Jacob Labertu, cum laude, Emma Lander, summa cum laude, Stephen Mark Main, Sarah Marsiglio, magna cum laude, Dakota Nelson, magna cum laude, Isaiah Paget, Anthony Pazio, magna cum laude, Jacob Presson, magna cum laude, Samuel Reeves, Alexandra Ross, summa cum laude, Alicia Rothering, Harrison Schaefer, Sophia Shore, summa cum laude, Peyton Towers, cum laude, Benjamin Wassum, Samuel West, Philip White.
Associate of Arts degrees. Tyler Edwards. Taylor Frank. Ashley Kelly. Sydney Olslager.
Associate of Arts degrees in Leadership. Hannah Abel, Christine Abahudi, Faith Atkerson, Kyla Barnard, Cameron Bartmus, Hunter Bixler, Logan Bryant, Angela Burks, Bailey Calhoun, Jonathan Cardoza, Grace Connor, Timothy Dixon, Abby Dobbs, Michaela Drummond, Dylan Dirk, Paul Ellie Jr., Allison Goebel, Matthew Hoffman, Kevin Hoffren, Frankie Johnson, Melody Jordan, Miriam Kessinger, Sydney King, Hadassah Larimore, Connor Mason, Caitlin Maxey, Jonah Medeiros, Ian Moore, Hunter Murray, Benjamin Nicholson, Rosante Perry, Seth Pienchikowski, Carson Pope, Christian Reed, Rodriguez Roach, John Rosa, Isaiah Sandoval, Jasmine Taylor, Brianna Vanderlaan, Salem Ware, Mark Wood.
My fellow graduates, it's a privilege and honor to be in this ceremony with you. Although this didn't happen the way we probably wanted it to, it's happening. We are now official graduates. So congratulations to all of you. Would you join me in a prayer of benediction? Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this opportunity that we have to come and celebrate. God, this isn't the celebration that we had in mind, although we realize and honor and acknowledge that you are not caught off guard by anything that's happened. And Lord, in spite of it being not the way we had hoped that it is, we indeed celebrate. God, we thank you for all the hard work of all these graduates from both the undergrad and the seminary. Lord, all the hard work they've put in, all the hours of studying, all the papers written, all of the late nights, all of the Red Bull drank. Lord, we thank you for all that we have done. And God, thank you for allowing us to be here at this moment of celebration. God, to honor the achievements of all of these people. Lord, I thank you for them. So Lord, I just pray a prayer of blessing over each and every one of them as we all leave from here and go on to our prospective places of work and ministry and business. Lord, may we go remembering all that we have learned here, all that you have taught us at our time at Evangel and AGTS. Lord, I pray that every man and woman that has walked across and gotten their diploma, every one of them that have graduated, may we now be cast out into the world to shed your light, to spread your light, Lord, to show all that we've learned, the integration of our faith with our learning. And God, in the marketplace, in the home, in the business world, in the church, may our lights shine. May we represent Evangel, may we represent our families, and most importantly, may we represent you in all that we do. Thank you for this moment. Thank you for this opportunity. Be with us. Lord, we honor all those who had a part of us being where we are today, our families, our professors, our friends, our children, our parents, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord God. We bless them. We bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
So you think you're graduating? You are. I knew you could do it.
I know this has been a challenging time for many of you, but just think, you've made it. You have achieved your goal.
We faculty are so grateful that you've shared part of your life journey with us.
I miss your face around here already, but I know that God has great things in store for you, and I know that the world around us is desperate for what you have to offer.
You embody the character of Christ along with the competencies and grit of authentic leaders.
You are going to change the world by serving your communities in the best way you know how.
I'm so excited about how God is going to use each one of you to transform your world for His glory.
I'm so proud of you, and I know that you will continue to make us proud.
Congratulations.
Congratulations!
Congratulations!
Seriously. Congratulations!
Congratulations!
And I know 2020 has been definitely an interesting time, but just keep in mind that God has a plan for you. We are praying for you.
We have watched you persevere and excel through unprecedented times.
And we just want to say to you,
congratulations.
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 A huge shout out to our adult and graduate studies graduates who have sacrificed and balanced the demands of work and family and school, and you've all done it beautifully.
You came here and you earned your degrees, and now God has the next step ready for you.
Congratulations.
I just wanted to let you know how proud we are of you for finishing your degree this semester.
You're already trendsetters. Who knew?
Everyone in counseling services is super proud of the job you've done and super honored to have traveled with you the last few years.
And we want to wish you well on your great adventure. So pursue the Lord and pursue that which you cannot not do.
And we will all continue to be your biggest fans as you move into the next season, whatever it is God has planned for you. Please remember that you are loved, you're believed in, and we miss you so much.
And I'm sending you big hugs. Love you all, but most of all,
congratulations.
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 We can't wait to hear your updates of where you are going on your journey.
Congratulations.
We have studied together, prayed together, laughed together, spent so many hours in the library, and we've eaten more chicken tenders than should ever be allowed. And today we get to graduate together.
And it's a little bittersweet because you guys are leaving, but I know that wherever you guys go next, you'll bring that same light and you'll impact people just as much as you impacted this campus.
Receive this benediction from Numbers chapter 6. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Amen.
Congratulations!